Русская атомная электростанция будет повреждена и произойдет катастрофа, непременно, сразу же, по центрам принятия решения прилетают две ракеты. Одна в Вашингтон, вторая в Лондон. Ядерные. Все.
Это приведет к запуску протокола взаимного уничтожения. Поэтому я бы все-таки, если честно, воздерживался от таких заявлений.
Person you saw in that video is Yury Kot, leader of the described as pro-Russian. I hate when people use that sort of term. Paris movement, talking about if this now Ukrainian-controlled, like in terms of the operation, but Russian-controlled in terms of the territory, nuclear plant. If it is damaged, then what Russia should do is immediately nuke London and DC or maybe New York. It depends on which state media broadcast that determines which US city is going to be nuked. Interestingly, that is maybe the first time that I've seen someone on one of these programs on Russian state TV immediately respond with, well, but then they would nuke us, so maybe let's not do that. And I consider that to be progress on Russian state TV. It's easy for Yury Kot to be like, I think we should nuke everybody, and then forget that then they would be nuked. It's a bad thing for anyone, let's not do it. But you know, bold statements aside from Russian state TV, we are in a very tense situation in terms of this particular nuclear power plant. Let's see, there's they've been threatening, and not just state media, but generals and stuff have been threatening to bomb it if necessary. The head of Russia's nuclear, biological, and chemical protection troops apparently claimed that they'd mined it and they're ready to blow it up if they have to, saying there will be either Russian land or a scorched desert. The enemy knows that the station will be either Russians or no one's. We are ready for the consequences of this step, which would of course be, you know, nuclear, you know, debris and nuclear, like the fumes and the fallout and all that going all over potentially Europe and Russia, let alone if that leads other countries to either escalate the traditional war or use weapons of mass destruction, including nuclear weapons. It's an insane thing to do, particularly because it ain't super clear who has actually been threatening this power plant. It is, again, disputed, each side saying the other is accidentally hitting it with RPGs and things like that. But we are once again in that part of the conflict where people are openly talking about nuclear war once again.
Yeah, because that's where I guess the leaders of the world like to push these types of things. Again, look, tons and tons of people's absolute existence rests in the hands of folks that talk like this, that say things like this. And it's not just Russians. We see how Donald Trump likes to talk and the types of things he likes to declare and types of threats he likes to make. And look, I saw this as a headline. I wanted to have a chance to read it before I really dug deeper, but it made some sense and I hadn't even thought about it. But someone else is saying all of the unrest and the battles, and specifically now as Donald Trump gets investigated to a further extent, and then the response coming from so many folks that support him based off of nothing, there's many opportunities for people to say, look at the imbalance, look at the fragile nature of this democracy happening over here where everyone has always touted it. And look, there's openings there. Look, now you can trust us. Hey, you never know what they're gonna do. Hey, look how they've gone after this guy. Whatever the support lands for folks politically, this spreads further than just Donald Trump. But people are dead set on just the Donald Trump thing. And now, look, we've got folks in other countries like this talking about, hey, if this happens, again, off of this conflict that everyone was talking about a few months ago, now no one is even paying much attention to, at least from our point of view over here in America with our politics. Mm-hmm. Then what's the consequences then later? And I'm not saying it's Russia that's coming to get us or any of those types of things, but perception of America has always been the thing that floats us past so many types of conflicts. And if that perception's off, we might have more conflicts.
Yeah, 100%. Yeah, I thought it was important that we talk about this just because you know, it's been some time since the Ukraine conflict was really like front page news, but it's continuing. People are dying like constantly. Yeah. Like I think the estimate of like just Russian losses is like 300 casualties a day still. This is still very significant. And you know, we've gotten past some difficult times, but that doesn't mean that this is not going to escalate. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.